Actually, I want to get both of your opinions on this. So early on in my career as a BCBA, I released a video, and I won't leave too many details, but like I released a video that was about a topic that I'm very passionate about. And I quoted an author in the video, and I was ecstatic to see that he actually reached out to me and said like, hey, liked your video. Thank you for sharing this information about my article. But here are a few things that when you oversimplified them, really kind of muddied up the entire rest of the video. And he was very, very nice. And I was so happy that he sent me that feedback, and I replied back thanking him because he was someone I looked up to in the field, or still look up to in the field. And it was interesting because in my mind, my first gut reaction, and I was kind of a fresh BC at the time, BCBA at the time, was to be like, well, of course I had to water it down because I can't make an hour long video explaining this super complicated topic. So I had to do that in order to get the point across, to bring more awareness. And I'm curious what your thoughts are on how you walk that line of not boring someone to death so they stop listening to the dissemination that you're trying to do, especially if it's a layperson.
Who do you want to go first, Hank?
Let's go with Dr. Hank.
Okay.
Well, our verbal behavior is under audience control. And so I think if you understand who your audience is, then you can, you know, consciously and intentionally tweak your verbal behavior so that it has the effect that it does on that particular audience. So if your video is just out there, if it's out there for parents, well, then yeah, you can't do what the person who wrote to you said. You know, you have to do what you did. If your audience is going to be other BCBAs or behavior analysts, then you have to hope that you can go into some of those details and talk in a more technical way. And I say hope because I'm not sure all the BCBAs, you know, are at that level of training, but
yes, you are. You're sure.
You're right. I am sure. You're right. I am sure. But I think, you know, you have to look at who your audience is, and then you carve out what you're going to say for the audience, and you do the best you can in terms of, you know, communicating and conveying what you want to convey. So I don't know what Paulie thinks about that. But
I love it. You go right back to behavior. You know, you've got it under the audience control. And that's it. I think you're speaking to the audience. So if you know, what is it you're trying to get? What do you want them to understand? And if you put a bunch of jargon out there, they're not going to understand shit. And they're probably going to turn them off the field. I want the audience to look. All right. So I need their attention first. I need them to look. And then I want them to consider them maybe adopting some simple, you know, my audience. I want to give to people outside the field. That's where my focus are. Some basic principle, some procedure that, you know, comes from our field. But then to Hank's point, if you're speaking to another group, then yeah, you do have to keep it sound. But I do some stuff with World Behavior Analysis Day and trying to, you know, I'm on the board there and disseminating the science. And, you know, I took some liberties with a recent video because, like, to your point, Billy, I would have two groups of people listening. Behavior analysis, who are taking pride in the field. And then there are other people who are trying to say, come over, man. We have the greatest science in the effing world. You know, there's nothing better than the science. Come check it out.